This is the Headless Professor, and I'm talking about what really makes something an experiment. This was brought to mind by the fact that I just recently came back here to my home in Acapulco, and I haven't been here since spring break, and it's now late December. Well, I noticed some things. For example, let's take a look at my alkaments. This fell down on the floor, and watch how it rolls. It's rolling funny, because when I looked inside, all the little tablets were stuck together. And that is null. You know how they tell you to store instant coffee in a cool, dry place? Well, I bought this instant coffee about a year ago, and look what's happened to it. It's all melted down. And you know what? The seal isn't even broken. Well, this is my office here in the house, and the temperature is a constant 81 degrees all year long, whether it's New Year's Eve or a July afternoon. Now, this coagulation of my coffee and my alkaments, is that an experiment? Is the dependent variable, what you see here, the results, and is the independent variable being left here for a long time in a hot room? Does that constitute an experiment? Well, I would say no. It's simply an observation of the results and my inference about what the most likely independent variable was. This is not an experiment because I really didn't manipulate an independent variable. If I had made it a formal experiment, I would have bought at least two of these jars of coffee. I would have left one here in my office with the 80 degree temperature, and I would have put the other one in the refrigerator and see if there's a difference. In other words, a good experiment does more than just manipulate an independent variable. It also tries to control any possible confounding variables. For example, I should get the same brand of coffee and make sure it has the same expiration date in the same size container. I would try to control all those variables, and the only variable that I would manipulate would be the temperature at which I store the coffee. And of course, if you're dealing with human subjects, there's one more thing you should be doing. You should have a larger sample size. That's because there's simply more variability between human beings than there is between different jars of coffee. So, keep up your observations, but realize that a formal experiment requires a little bit more than simply observing a dependent variable and trying to infer the possible cause.